must be spitting out hunter killers too. It's my stash. I don't know if it's antlers will stop it from gouging me.
is Romeo requesting status update. Flight 41, you need to adjust your course to avoid the swarm. Can you respond? Over. Flight 41, please acknowledge. My sensors are showing their cabin is depressurized. I think the crew's gone and they're on autopilot. Flight 41 is a ghost flight.
Whatever happened to the people on that plane? I'm not going to respond. There must be another crashed plane out there. Ancient ruin turned into a Tanakh stronghold. Could Aether be inside? Poking around's not going to be easy with Tanakh's warriors everywhere.
Many more soldiers killed since. Amigala's army only grows in strength.
She struck a blow to us at the embassy. This much is true, but we are made of steel. We will not yield. Regala's forces may seem strong now, but...
Her machines took out my entire squad.
Remember the visions. The old ones didn't choose their fight, but still, they stood firm. They didn't falter. And neither will we. Blood of the Ten. You've come to us.
You know who I am?
Oh, the warrior with hair like wildfire who defeated Regala's champion at Baron Light. Yes, you are known to us. I am Dekka, chaplain of the Lolan clan. You've come to speak with Chief Hikaru.
Not quite. There's something I need here.
Anything you need, the chief will provide. Come.
Is that one of the visions you were talking about?
Yes. The records of the Ten. I can show you them, if you like. On the way to the chief.
These visions... You said they're the records of the Ten. Who are they?
Old ones. Who fought a heroic battle against machines on this very soil long ago. Their deeds are honored in the visions. At least what remains of them. To be remembered and exalted.
There used to be more of these visions?
Many more. Once this place was filled with light and sound. But over the years, they've fallen into darkness. One by one. That is why chaplains are so important to the tribe. We remember all we can of the visions. Etched in our flesh, passed down by word of mouth from generation to generation. One day the whole grove may go dark, but chaplains who come after me will keep the memories alive.
Why does Hikaru want to see me?
We are at war with Regala, and you've already shown that you can stand against her.
I'm not here to fight a war for you.
Not for us. With us. But I won't try to persuade you. That is for the chief. He can be very convincing.
What does it mean to be a chaplain here?
We who outlast our youth study the visions and share their wisdom with our young.
What kind of wisdom?
How to be a true warrior. To fight with bravery and unflinching honor. And to know when to call for peace. You can see for yourself when we go inside.
All right, let's go see Chief Hikaru.
He's in his throne room at the far end of the grove. Come. Be welcome among the records of the Ten.
Come, you soldier of the Ten.
It's glitched. Incomplete.
Their full truths are lost to us. It's the chaplain's duty to make sense of these visions as best we can.
Led by weapons were
the Ten were dedicated soldiers, working together as a squad and sharing in their duty. And when the time came for battle, they took to the skies and leaped to glory. All Tanakh seek to follow their example. Before the chief, it was one of the few things the clans had in common. During their war, the Ten climbed sheer rock, braving blinding snow and wind. They stopped at nothing to protect their own.
You make them sound invincible.
They weren't. But the visions tell us of their courage and strength, something our soldiers aspire to. The Sky Clan admires this one above all the rest. They make their home in the mountains northwest of here.
What's this one about?
The Ten waged war against their enemy in the desert heat, a land too harsh for any to survive. But against all odds, they prevailed. So the Desert Clan does the same. You must have passed through their territory on the way here.
I did. They seem a little extreme.
They take that as a compliment.
Stash this away for later. Soldiers in a jungle. Those were the Ten?
Yes. They knew how to use the jungle's depths to distract the enemy until the perfect moment to strike. Generations ago, my clan, the Lowland, looked to this one for inspiration as they claimed the jungle to the southwest.
Hey, Outlander!
You have an old world recording? This box was speaking with voices of the old ones. But now there's noise over them. Let me take a look. Where did you find this?
We took it from an Asaram Delver. She was trying to steal it, and other artifacts from Tanakh territory. The others were going to bury it in the sand with her. But then I heard the voices.
Well, the data here is badly corrupted, but...
Delta Juliet 9, you are weapons-free and clear to engage the swarm. Good hunting.
Copy that. We'll buy Zero Dawn the time you need. Delta Juliet 9, out.
The voices of warriors from the past. And that Asaram wanted to sell them for shards. The bravery of the Ten should be remembered.
I'm not sure what you mean by the Ten. These voices came from the final battle of the Old Ones.
Another battle? I could learn more about it if I could find the other boxes. That Delver did say there might be more recordings to be found in the wreckage of ancient flying machines. She claimed she had a way to locate them.
Yeah. The box with the voice data on it is emitting a locator signal. I could use it to find the others.
If you do then, bring them back here. I will see to it that they're treated with proper respect. Whatever sacrifices were made by these ancient soldiers, we will honor them.
I've already found a recording.
I'll take any you find. Let me give you something for it. These voices will be kept here. They will be remembered.
Why do you want these recordings?
Every battle teaches its soldiers. We should learn those lessons and honor those who fell. That is our way.
Do you get many Asaram Delvers in Tanakh's territory?
Fewer every time we catch them, but those thieving rats would do anything for the shards. There'll always be some who'll risk coming here.
And what do you do with the ones you catch?
Delvers spend their lives in the dust. So we bury them in it. Alive.
If I find more of those recordings, I'll bring them back to you. My focus can detect beacons from those recording devices. Should help me to find any others that are still out there. What's this?
It was planted there by the chief. Ask him if you're curious. It's his tale to tell.
Okay.
The chief is inside. Are you ready to see him?
I'm ready.
Good. Come.
Underneath the throne.
Oh, We'll see you soon, Outlander.
The savior of Meridian. I am told you held back Regala's forces outside Baron Light. And defeated her champion, Grutta, in single combat. Impressive.
I met Fashav there, too. He said you were a great warrior. And a man of honor.
His death is a painful loss among many. We will not soon recover from the massacre of our marshals. But if you are here to pledge your service, that could help considerably.
I am not here to fight for you. I need something in that basement. Something that will save many lives, yours included. It's not something you can see, but it is there.
I have seen it. You have named your price. Now I name mine. With my marshals dead, I need your spear. Help me defeat my enemies, and I will grant you access to the chamber below.
I don't have a price. I am not a hired killer. I'm here to save lives, more than you can count.
I count the corpses of marshals slain. I count hundreds more to knock them, whose lives hang in the balance. I will fight for them. I will kill anyone who threatens the peace, and you will too, if you want me to open the door to the chamber below.
Okay. So by that logic, what's stopping me from killing you right now, and taking what I need to save everyone?
You could try. You might even succeed. Either way, you must fight. My way might hold off Regala and the slaughter she craves.
Fine. What do you need?
I need more marshals to keep the tribe together. Such warriors can only be promoted at a trial by combat called the Cool Root. I've sent out a call for the competition. But since Regala seeks to undermine me, she is certain to attack it. She'll want to kill me in front of the assembled clans.
So what, you want me to be your bodyguard?
No. To defend the Cool Root. But there is more. Knowing Regala will attack, one of the clans have balked at sending their contestants. You must go north and force Tikote, the commander of the Sky Clan, to submit and send his best.
Force him to submit?
Do whatever is necessary. I can't hold the Cool Root with two of the three clans in attendance. Marshal Katala will assist you. He was maimed at Baron Light, but he can still be of use. I sent him ahead to the northern village of Stone Crest. Meet him there, and he will guide you to the Sky Clan stronghold. If you have any questions about your mission, now is the time.
I'm sorry about Fashav. He seemed like a good man.
More than a man. A bridge between Tanakh and Karja. No Outlander ever earned our respect as he did. I had hoped he would be my voice in Meridian. That peace with the Karja might become something more.
An alliance?
An exchange. The Karja have much we lack. Our deeds are written in ink upon our bodies. Our memories die with our flesh. But the Karja never forget. Their deeds are written in book and scroll.
You wanted to learn from them?
As I learned from Fashav. He will be missed.
Fashav called Regala your greatest mistake. Why?
That is not your concern.
Really? I fought against her forces at Baron Light, and I don't even know what her problem is.
She was the deadliest of my marshals. The point of my spear.
So what happened?
Above all, Regala despises the Karja who burned her younger brothers alive. After we turned back the Red Raids and tore down the battlements of Baron Light, She hoped to chase them all the way to Meridian. She could not see the cost of such a war, nor the benefits of peace after the Mad Sun King fell. When I accepted Avad's entreaties, she went mad, called me traitor, challenged me before the marshals.
What did you do when Regala challenged you?
If you were to knock, you would know that such a challenge cannot be refused. It was not easy to subdue her. I bear 7 scars from that fight. The other marshals wanted me to execute her on the spot, but I found I could not sever the bond between us. Her loyalty had been as boundless as her rage, so I spared her. Rather than mercy, she took it as a humiliation, one she will never be free from.
What exactly is the Kulrut?
Where once the clans fought each other, now we fight as one, against the machines. That is my law made manifest in the Kulrut. Each clan must send contestants whenever I call for the ritual. These contestants face trial by combat against machines in an arena just beyond these walls. Those who distinguish themselves become marshals who bind the tribe together as peacekeepers.
Why won't the Sky Clan send contestants to the Kulrut?
Of the 3 clans, they have the most defensible base, protected by a mighty wall called the Bulwark. Their commander believes he can wait out the war between Regala's forces and my own, safe behind his barrier.
Staying strong, while you and Regala weaken each other.
You think like a seasoned marshal. Good.
You called them peacekeepers, but the marshals I met at the embassy were warriors.
Warriors, yes, but more. They renounced the clan that birthed them and pledged themselves to order and peace. They enforce my law. They settle disputes and stand for Tanakh in parley with other tribes. Without them, I cannot rule. Which is why you must ensure the next Kulrut takes place.
You said you saw what's in the basement?
I did. On the day of my greatest victory.
What do you mean?
For a dozen generations, the 3 clans battled for control of this hallowed ground. Only I achieved it. I fought for years, killed whoever stood in my way. When I had finally slain all rivals, I stood alone in the grove. Victory was mine to savor, or so I thought. Thunder roared from the east, and a bolt of blue struck this place. That chamber.
Gaia dies, and Aether arrives.
All around me, the visions of the grove grew louder and brighter, and suddenly a new one appeared before me. The old one spoke. And what they said changed everything.
What did the old one say to you in this new vision?
The one called Faraday foretold the growing danger of the machines and said we must unify to stop them. She called for marshals to enforce the peace. Then the vision faded, never to be seen again. I marked the spot where it shone with my spear. And I took Faraday's words to heart. Renounced war between the clans. Trained warriors to fight machines. Ordained marshals through the Kulrut. Since then, the tribe has been at peace. Until Regala attacked at Barren Light.
And the chamber beneath the throne. You went in after the vision?
I did. Inside is an ancient device. It hums with power. You will see it for yourself after the Kulrut. This I swear.
Why send me to deal with the Sky Clan?
All Tanakh respect strength, and you drove Regala back at Barren Light.
That and most of your marshals are dead?
Correct.
What about Katalo? Can't he do it by himself?
He is maimed. They will no longer respect him.
That hardly seems fair.
What is fair about losing an arm? Whether they respect him or not, Katalo still has worth. He knows the Sky Clan. He was raised in their base. He will guide you well.
I'll do what you want, and go north to deal with Dakota. But you'd better not forget about our deal.
You will have what was promised, if you succeed. Speak to Deka on your way out. She will arm you for the road ahead.